Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be filming my kind of nightly routine, but also my pamper-ish routine, like my at-home spa day, because I'm finally done with my freshman year and I'm back home for a day or two, and then I'm leaving to go back home to like San Antonio. So I just want to like take a little time to detox, and so I'm just going to show you guys what I do to kind of do that. So the first thing that I do is a face mask, but I just kind of just take a look at my skin and think about what I need, and if I have a bunch of pimples, then I'm probably going to do something with like tea tree, or if I need to exfoliate, if I've been spending a lot of time in the sun, then I'm going to do something hydrating and exfoliating, and you know the basics. So today I've been spending a lot of time in the sun, and I'm stressed, and I'm breaking out, so I'm just going to use my little Juice Beauty cleanser. I'll put the link down below, but this one's really awesome because it's all natural. And it's a green apple peel, so it's going to kind of take off the first layer of my skin, which is going to exfoliate it, but it's also drying. So it's going to dry my pimples. I was reading the label, sorry, to make sure that it was. And it's also age-defying, so it just feels really good, though. It's got a nice kind of sting, so that's what I like. You know, it's working whenever it's painful. So I'm just going to apply that to my face. I'm going to use just a little tiny flat brush, and yeah, that's what I'm going to do. And I'm going to leave it on for about 15 minutes and start filling up my bath. I'm going to take a bubble bath, and I'm going to start filling that up and waiting for all that to get ready after. Also, quick tip, always take it down the neck because that ages too, my friends. So, like I said, I'm just going to leave that on for about 15 minutes, fill up my bath, and I'll film that and show you all the kind of bath products and stuff I use too. So, see you in a second. Alright, hey guys, so I'm in my bathroom now. Sorry if it's kind of hard to hear me. I'm filling up the bathtub. So, yeah, all I'm going to be doing is taking a nice little bath and the lights and candles, and I'm going to do a bath bomb. We here in Savannah locally have this place called Nourish. It's really similar to Lush, except everything. I mean, Lush is all natural too, I think, but I'm going to turn the bath water off really quick, just to make sure you can hear me. Okay, sorry, that's off now. So I'm just going to do a bath bomb from there. Focus, please. Alright, so I'm just gonna do bath bomb from there. They just look like this. I'm gonna do one that smells like raspberries. This smells really good, and it's got like little fruity chunks in it and stuff. So I'm just gonna do that, and I'm also gonna exfoliate and shave and do all of that good stuff because I'm also gonna be doing my fake tan tonight. So I'm just gonna scrub up all my old tan, anything that I have. Yeah, that's all I'm gonna do, really. Let me show you guys my bathroom, though, because it is so cute. We just moved into our new house, and it's all retro-themed, so I'm just going to turn this around and show you guys. So here's the bathroom. Sorry if the rug is, like, a little bit dirty. Yeah, all the tiles are so cute. It's, like, 50s-themed. I've got a nice little closet bathtub. It's so cute, and the walls are blue. Here's our little decorations. And I'm going to go ahead and just go light, if I can find my finger, that candle, and I'm gonna go ahead and get in. Alright, hey guys, so I'm back from taking my nice relaxing bath. So, like I said, all I did in that was use some exfoliant. I'll link it down below if I can, but it's from a local, like a local boutique here in Savannah, so I don't know if they sell online. But I'll try to link it down below because it's so amazing. It's piña colada scented, and I love it, and it makes your skin so soft. And then I just shaved my legs to prepare all of my skin for my fake tanner. The one I'm going to be using is Loving Tan. But before I go ahead and apply my fake tanner, I'm just going to put on some lotion. The one I use, one second, over here. One of my favorite lotions is just the little Eos ones. Let me focus. just the little Eos ones. They're really nice because, like, I'm really picky about my lotion. I don't like it to feel super sticky or greasy and heavy. And these are really light and it smells really good. So this one's probably one of my favorites. So I'm just going to go ahead and put that all over my body. And then the moisturizer I use for my face is actually just this stuff. It's Jergens Natural Glow for your face. And I use this just because the fake tanner on my face, like, it fades pretty fast because I use exfoliating washers and all that kind of stuff. So it usually comes off faster, so I like to keep it matching my neck by using this stuff. This is my natural tan right now. I'm pretty tan, but I'm about to go home, so I just want to give it, like, that extra kick, you know. And one more thing I forgot to mention before I got in the bath, I also did a deep conditioner on my hair, and one of my favorites is this one from Wella Professionals, and I'll link it down below as well. It's just a reconstructing mask. As you guys know, I dye my hair a lot, and so I just wanted to give it a lot of extra moisturization, so all I'm going to do is just put on my lotion and go blow dry my hair, and then I'll be back. So I'm back a little bit later. I went out with some friends and I didn't want to do my fake tan, so I'd be all smelly whenever I went out with them. So now I'm just going to do my fake tan, but before I do that, I just want to throw out a couple tips out there. I know I've done a blog post on it, but just a couple tips to make sure that you get the most even, natural looking tan. Like I said, I don't know how many times in my video, but make sure you go in and exfoliate everywhere. Let me zoom out a little bit here. I just exfoliated all over my body and I shaved, so made sure it's all new, fresh skin. Same thing goes on my face. I did an exfoliant there too. And then you want to, I moisturized all over my body and then waited about 2 or 3 hours until it set in so that the tan would still stick to my skin. But if you're in a rush, just put it in your dry areas, like your elbows, your knees. I sometimes put it, like, right in the fold of my armpit and all over my face and hands and feet. So yeah, so now it's a couple hours later and I've done my lotion, and last thing I'm going to do before I apply my fake tan is just take some Neosporin and apply it to the like dry patches where I might have had, like, an existing breakout where it's kind of like a scab now, because that's gonna make the fake tanner not stick to those areas and turn them super, super dark, which is what we don't want, because I don't wanna look all spotty on my face. So I'm just gonna go ahead and do that. Let me grab a mirror really quick. So I just use, excuse how messy it is, but just the Loving Tan in the shade Ultra Dark. I really love this stuff. It's, like, ultra dark, which is what I like. I'm just gonna go ahead and start applying this. I've already applied my lotion and all that kind of good stuff. So, yeah. All I really do, I guess if you guys really want to see this part, I can do it. I'll just do my arms. I do, like, 3 pumps for an arm and 4 for my legs. And I just go ahead and start rubbing it in. But I'll just apply it so you guys can see the initial shade that you get. And now I'll go ahead and do the rest of my body off camera because I'm not trying to get naked for you guys. There's creeps out there. So as you can see, there's really a nice initial deposit of color. And the nice thing about it is it doesn't really wash off. Like, you know, I hate how whenever you go to do fake tan, let me try to focus this a little bit more, and you, like, you feel so tan, and you go get in the shower, and all the tan washes off, and you're almost the same color you were before. But this doesn't do that, so I really like it. So if you guys want to see side-by-side comparison, there it is, just right initially, you know. So that'll develop overnight. I'm also going to show you guys how I do my hands, because I know that's a really tricky area, so stay tuned. Alright, so I had just applied this stuff, and now I'm just taking my brush. This is a very strange angle, sorry folks, and applying it to my hands. Make sure you bend your knuckles whenever you're applying it to those, because it's gonna get inside those little cracks.
with your smile. Now the sunshine brings the light. Fill me out with a flame. I will let you in this game.
So there's before and after. Alright, so now I'm just going to go ahead and apply the fake tanner to my face with just a buffing brush. I'm just going to take a little teeny tiny amount, like not much. And look in the mirror. I start on the outside of my face, make sure you get your ears. I just start blending it down the net.
Fill me out with your smile. Now the sunshine brings the light. Fill me out.
So there's the face done. Make sure you just keep it blended into your hairline and down the net. Looks good to me. Alright, so last but not least, I'm just going to be doing my gel manicure on my toes and my feet, but I'm just going to show you really fast my hands just for the sake of this video. And yeah, that's all I've got left in my pamper routine.
Fill me out with a flame. I will let you.